She's a shining jewel, a pure, shimmering mirage framing one of the world's prettiest cities. And just like a mirror of its land-based citizens, the waters of Sydney Harbour are reflecting a deeper image of shallow Sydney. Let me explain in one word.
Piss! Sydney Harbour is full of piss. But this story's not just about piss, you see. It's what's inside the piss that has scientists intrigued. So the pills that you're popping, Sydney, are ending up in the waterways, and let's just say that, well, little Nemo is pinging like a bastard.
Don't do that!
Well, sort of. You see, a Sydney University study sampled water from around Sydney Harbour, searching for micropollutants that come from sewerage, and what they found was surprising.
We didn't know what was out there, and we just wanted to see if we could detect anything, basically. And we did detect a lot of these chemicals, but at very, very low concentrations. And so we don't know what effect that's going to have on the ecosystem or human health.
Found in the waters of Sydney Harbour were painkillers like codeine, paracetamol and tramadol, antidepressives like venlafaxine and fluoxetine, beta blockers like propranolol and artificial sweetener like acesulfame.
As the population ages, people are taking more and more pharmaceuticals, and so it's a worldwide trend that more of these pharmaceuticals and medicines are actually getting into the ecosystems.
pH is 7.55.
In the US, psychologists are trying to tackle the problem of estrogen coming from the contraceptive pill, which gets flushed into waterways. One study has shown that the heightened estrogen is making male fish grow ovaries where their testes should be. In Taiwan, after more than 600,000 festival goers rocked out at Spring Scream, nearby rivers were found to contain a huge range of illegal and illegal drugs like MDMA and antibiotics. The fear is that the water treatment facilities are ill-equipped to process such huge amounts of lifestyle-related chemicals. Back in Sydney, these micropollutants reveal a secret that Sydneysiders might not want you to know.
The biggest surprise was the wide distribution, and that's, I mean, spatially wide distribution of these chemicals. And secondly, that we shouldn't really see them in estuarine water at all, because the sewage system in Sydney is separated from the stormwater system.
But it's not all bad, guys. Remember, Sydney Harbour is also a little bit sweeter, with that most prevalent chemical, the artificial sweetener.
Augusto Sweetheart.
Market that to the tourists.